One of the most common imbalances you'll see with your clients and with yourself is overpronation, and that's a collapsing of the feet and ankles. One of the easiest assessments you can do to see if you or your clients overpronate is ask your client to stand in front of you or take a look at yourself and the way you stand. And if you stand with your feet turned out or abducted, so that means with the feet turned out, it is indicative that you overpronate. And let me make that make sense to you. When you overpronate, which is a collapsing inwards of the feet and ankles, the ankles and feet roll towards the midline of the body. That rotates the shins in and the knees in. As a compensation for that collapsing of the leg inwards, you turn your feet out. So if you see you or your clients with their feet turned out, it is suggestive that you overpronate. And a quick fix for this is called the big toe pushdown. So coach your clients to put their feet straight. So if their ankles and feet are collapsing inwards, they're transferring weight across the inside of the foot versus transferring weight forward into their toes and using the toes as a brake to increase their balance and decrease the stress to their body. So the exercise is this. Feet straight, raise the arches, bend down and get your toes straight, because you can see her big toes a little bit facing east and west, so we want her big toes straight. And then she's going to gently keep the arches raised and push the big toe down. There's a muscle called the flexor hallucis longus, and it runs down here on the inside of the foot, on the underside of the foot, and helps push the big toe down. Now you can see and you can feel that muscle working. And just stand up nice and tall. So she's got the arches raised and she's pushing the big toe down. Now she, when she, if she was to rock forward gently, so she's going to transfer weight gently forward, and she pushes her big toe down, she's going to feel that muscle working, but most importantly, she's going to be transferring weight forward into the toes, because that muscle is acting like a brake, versus doing what she typically does, just relax. What you typically do when you rock forward is you rock forward and everything rolls in, and you don't use the rest of your foot, especially your big toe, as a brake to help you transfer weight forward. And when you collapse inward, there's nothing helping you slow down stress, so all that impact from the ground goes back up through the body, causing stress to the ankles, knees, hips, lower back, and so forth. So the big toe pushdown, which is simply the exercise to raise the arches, align the toes, and then gently rock forward, pushing the big toe down into the ground to strengthen that muscle, will help her decrease overpronation and decrease all those stresses she gets as a result to her ankles, knees, hips, and back, and so forth.